Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel Learn Web Coding. My name is Durgesh Sahani and we are creating series of video tutorials for Docker. So in the previous session we have seen Docker images for PHP and Apache, how to pull that image and execute it on our local machine. Now in this session I'm going to show you how to create a Docker file and build an image on top of that. Okay, so let's start now. So just go to the documentation page and I'll brief you about a Docker file. So go to the best practices for writing Docker file. So here they have explained in detail what is Docker file and what are the keywords you should use inside your Docker file. Now I'm going to give you a very basic information of some required or most of the time we are using that keywords. And if you want to read in depth, then obviously you can go here and read it. So first thing is you should create a Docker file like this. D capital and rest of the characters are in small letter without any extension. Then the sample Docker file they have given. So what I will do is I'll use Docker file instructions. So here you can see you should use from to pull some images whatever you want, and they should be the first line of your Docker file. Then if you want to write some label, then obviously you can use this label. The next one is, the next important keyword is run. So what run is do, if you want to execute multiple commands in your system, then you can use this run, and by using backslashes you can combine it like this. Here you can see it is executing these two commands, and then you have some several others commands you want to combine in a single one, then you can use backslashes, and at the next line you can write those commands. Okay, now the next important one is CMD. So CMD is similar to run, but if you want to execute some commands and want to pass some argument into it, then in that case you should use CMD. So for example, you can see CMD execute Apache 2 in along with these parameters, right? Now the next one is expose. So if you want to publish any port from your container, then in that case you can use expose keyword. Then the next one is env. So if you want to set some path into your system path variable, then you can use env. For example, you can see here how they are setting this path variable, right? Now the next one is add or copy. So if you want to transfer some files from your local machine to container, then in that case you can use copy commands. So here you can see the example, copy this file into the temp directory. Okay, entry point. So if you want to execute some command and you want to set some entry points, so whenever you execute some command, so it should refer the previous set entry point. So for example, you want to execute this command hyphen hyphen help, in that case it will take this command default and execute this help. Okay, so if you want to read more about it in depth, obviously you can come here and read it. So I'll start from here. I'll write a Docker file and we'll use our commands here, and whenever I'll use it, I'll explain it here only. Okay, so let's create a Docker file and say Docker file. So our Docker file is created, and here we have to specify from which command you want to pull. So as in previous session we have seen, we are using PHP 7.4-Apache. So the first line is ready. Now what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to pull this image. Okay, so as we already have into if I show you Docker images, so I already have this image at my local machine, so it will take reference of this image, it will not download it from Docker Hub. Now the next line is, and if you want to see some more information about how to create a Docker file, so here you will see, yes, Apache with Docker file. So from, you have to specify the PHP, then tag, and after that copy your code or whatever file you have into this directory. Okay, so the next thing we have to say, copy source and destination. So for me, I want to transfer the site folder inside our destination. So I'll here I have images of Docker image, and then I have some libraries, CSS, fonts, JS, and our main file. So I want to transfer this site folder. So here I'll write source site directory inside where www and HTML. Okay, now this one is done. One more thing I will do, which is I'll expose a port 80, and we are done. That's it. Now we have to build this image, and how to build it, here you can see Docker build hyphen T and then name of the image and dot. So we have to say, first we have to go to the directory where so in my case a Docker file is in D drive, then tutorials, then Docker. Here you can see, so I'll go over there first, CD tutorials Docker, and as I have shown you, you can see my Docker file is here. So I'll say here Docker build dash T, and you can provide some name. So I'll say PHP Apache. Okay, so this is what our image name I want to give. You can say PHP Apache like this. Oops, I forgot that dot. Now it will prepare our image, and if you say Docker images, you can see PHP underscore Apache image is created with tag latest. Now if you want to run this command, this container or that image, then you have to say Docker run hyphen D is for if you want to run this command in background for that, and then hyphen hyphen name if you want to give some name to your container, and then finally name of your image. So I'll say Docker run, and I'll say I for interactive mode of command line. Then I'll say hyphen hyphen rm. So hyphen hyphen rm is used to remove the container as soon as it will stop. Now the next one is I'll say name hyphen hyphen name, and we'll give name Docker container name PHP container. Okay, then the next one is hyphen P is used to expose the port. So we are going to say use the 80 port, and we are binding with from inside and outside both 8080. Now the next one is we have to specify the image name. So image name is PHP hyphen Apache. Okay, now if you run this command, it will start your container. So you can see here our Apache is it's started, and this is the location it was trying to set, but in Windows machine it won't work. So simply you can use the 127.0.0.1 and it will work for you. Otherwise you can use localhost, and you are getting this warning message. You can ignore it for now. I'll show you in the further how you can remove it. So see, this is at my local machine. If you see here, it is my local machine, and I already have XAMPP which is running. So you can see here my XAMPP is running, and Apache service is running. So I'll just stop it and just stop this MySQL also. If you refresh, now it is not running. But if I'll say localhost, so you can see it is running, and now it is running from the container. Okay, so if you want to verify if you are okay, but it won't work because I have not mounted the code. Let me show you. If I'll say h1, and here I just want to print the PHP version. So I'll say PHP and let's echo PHP version. Okay, So just refresh this page, and it is not affecting here because we have not mounted our file. So let's start it, and if you refresh this page again, you can see you will see that I'm running PHP 7.2.1 at my local machine, but at production, in container, we are having 7.4. But it is whenever I'm refreshing it, I'm not getting that. Now let's stop it and refresh it again. The changes which I have made here is not reflecting into our container. So how you can do, how to achieve that? So for that, let's close this and say docker ps hyphen a and stop it. Docker stop So I'm just going to stop this again, and if you see now, the docker images docker container is gone because we have stopped it, and as we have used hyphen hyphen rm, because of that it just get cleaned. Okay, now I'm going to run it again, but in now this time I'll provide one more argument, which is hyphen v. So v for volume, and here we have to say on D drive there is a file folder called tutorials/docker/site folder, and mount this folder with /www and then html. Okay, so we want to mount it, and now hit enter. You can see it started again, and if you go here and refresh this page, you are getting this PHP version. And if I'll make some changes over here, I'll say PHP version. Okay, and if you refresh this page, you can see PHP version -7.4.2, and here you can see 7.2.1, right? So my local machine was running on XAMPP, and it was the PHP version was this, and in Docker the PHP version is this. So I hope you have you understand the concept of how to create a Docker file, how to build an image, how to run that image, and how to mount it. Now one more thing I want to show here is, as you are getting this could not reliably determine the server's fully qualified domain name, so I'll show you how you can remove this warning. So for that you need to add one line of code into your Docker file, which is run echo server name. Basically what we are doing is we are adding server name localhost into our Apache config file. Okay, once it is done, and if you save this file and refresh build the image again, so that error will gone, but you'll get some other error. So I'll show you how to fix that error again. So what I'm going to do here is docker stop so it stopped now. Let's say docker images, and I'm going to remove this image also. So if you want to remove any image, you have to say docker rmi and name of image. So it's deleted now. Now you have to build that image again. Docker build hyphen t, let's say php apache again and dot. Now it will add this localhost into this config file again, and if you run this run command again, let's say run, now you can see that the warning message you are getting, it is no more here, right? So if you refresh this page again, you can see it is running for you. And if you make any changes over here of container and save this file, refresh, it is working. Okay, so I hope you understand all these concepts. So thank you very much guys for watching. If you like my videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, like my videos and share this video with your friends. And if you have any doubts, please do let me know in comment box. So thanks again for watching.